I might have made a total of 25 investments, out of which I think 7 or 8 are gone and forgotten. 7 or 8 may just return the principal. 6 will give a mid-teen, or 5 will give a mid-teen returns on my investment, and 5 will give me multiple returns. 10 times, 20 times, 30 times, 40 times. So overall, my portfolio has done well, and it has taught me a lot. Because when I first made a private equity investment in 2000, when I looked at those companies and I worked with them, I realized what is the blockage to growth. It has really improved my skills as an investor. Also, I think it's very taxing to do private equity investment, but it's very interesting that if I make a very good investment, and maybe in 3 years I double, treble my money, that doesn't mean that I should sell that investment. Because see, my targeted return on my portfolio is 18 to 20%. If even after trebling the investment can give me 18% return on the new value, I would not like to accept. But I feel that as companies get size, they get knowledge, they get experience, and opportunities open, I would like to retain my investment because I have no investor other than my wife. Right? As far as my private, I have really no strategy. I mean, most of my deals have been done without bankers. Most of my deal have been done by people have approached me. My KPO I set up as an idea because I like the entrepreneur very much. When I invest in Titan, I never knew that it will be Titan. Let me tell you. I was not as visionary as people think. Because you invest, you think the opportunity is good, time passes, you dig, you learn more, you understand. See, Nisha, we invest out of informed ignorance. Because I cannot say I've invested in a hospital chain, I've invested in a jewelry company, I've invested in a KPO. I'm not investing in a health business, I've invested in a shoe marketing company, I've invested in a pharma company. So, you know, we have to realize we cannot be invest out of informed ignorance. And second thing is, today in the listed space, because of regulatory reasons, you cannot know more than you are not able to know more than up to a certain point. So I don't, you know, when I make an investment, I look at the direction, I look at the people, I look at the opportunity, and I do it a lot by intuitive sense. What I feel is that everything can change economically. One thing is not going to change. That permanently stock market valuations are, you know, slaves of earnings. And I think we are anticipating too much of change, valuing, you know, it will take place, it will take time, and we are paying absurd valuations for it. COVID has financially been a very, very lucky thing for me. If I can say that, it's a human tragedy. Because I started investing at the bottom of the market in April. And my, you know, liquidity is now at its, you know, my debt is at the highest level and I don't want to go into any more debt. But I've invested in a variety of companies. I invested in pharma. I made a very large investment in Tata Steel and Telco Indian Defense. Jindal Steel. I mean, I've invested a lot of money in commodities because I feel this commodity cycle is here going to last for minimum 5 years. And the valuations were absurd, and according to me, in consonance to cash flows, the valuations are still absurd. And I've invested in a variety of things. I invested in a bank, I invested in a construction company, I added value, my investments there. Then, what else did I invest in? I put some money in Sun Pharma's research company now. So, a variety of companies I invest, but I'm fully invested. PSUs are mainly invested in banks. I'll tell you, State Bank and Can Bank. So I think the banks, you know, the people, I think credit growth in India traditionally is at least 1.25 to 1.5 times nominal GDP growth. And this, you know, credit growth, which has been 6-7%, is going to go to 15% according to me. I see India growing in double digit this year, and then next year 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I think by 2025, India will be growing double digits. That's my opinion. I have the right to be wrong. And I think credit growth will pick up, and the public sector banks are fully provided, in their provisions, and they also have deposit gathering ability. And State Bank, I can't imagine what price you're paying. Very well administered, very well run. First time he's a chairman for 5 years. They have YONO, they have, if somebody wants to borrow 5,000 crores, whom is he going to go to? They're doing very well in retail space. Their subsidiaries are doing extremely well. Nobody can match their distribution for all,
Yes.
insurance, retail, or for mutual funds.